Hello friends of human spaceflight, and welcome to another week in review as we look into the space industry and notable launch activities from around the world. Coming up, SpaceX lifted a variety of satellites to orbit this week as part of its Transporter 7 mission. In a first for any European spacecraft, an 8-year journey awaits Juice as it makes its way to mighty Jupiter. A small New Zealand company is getting it done with another test flight of its Aurora spaceplane completed recently. Starlink is going to start providing national cell coverage, but stick around to see why you can't use it. A truly amazing milestone is approaching for a tiny Martian helicopter that was only meant to make up to 5 flights. And just when you thought it was all over, Virgin Orbit brings something new to the table. There's plenty to cover here in this episode, so let's go! SpaceX were all set to go here for their Transporter 7 rideshare mission, the 7th installment in their innovative small satellite rideshare program. Liftoff occurred on Friday the 14th of April at 11:47 p.m. local time from the iconic Vandenberg Space Force Base in California, USA. Another textbook release from the launch pad as Falcon 9 rose into the night sky. Once through Max-Q, it was time to turn up the heat and go full throttle, and in no time at all, the main engines cut off and stages separated. The baton now passed to stage 2 as it continued on with the mission, taking some 51 assorted payloads deeper into space. The core stage flip and boost back burn saw the booster on the landing zone's doorstep soon after. Always impressive seeing the first stage execute a flawless vertical touchdown at landing zone 4. A mere 400 meters away from the launch pad, just 7.5 minutes after takeoff. Talk about a precision landing right there. This mission also marked the 10th launch and landing for the esteemed booster responsible for getting the payload into orbit. Back to the payloads now, and just after an hour from liftoff, here we go. A nice run of spacecraft popping goodness, releasing an array of CubeSats, Microsats, hosted payloads, and orbital transfer vehicles, each carrying a unique spacecraft set to be deployed over the next 90 minutes. Pretty much first in order of deployment were 3 high-resolution greenhouse gas monitoring satellites, C6, C7, and C8. 6 satellites were scheduled for launch in 2023, with these 3 to be followed by C9, C10, and C11 on a Virgin Orbit mission. Moving right along now. Let's talk a little about Juice, which is launching, all being well, the day after we have recorded this session. However, as we all know in the space industry, weather is not always kind. So this topic may appear again next week, but we're hoping not. We've got our fingers crossed for you, ESA. Delayed due to lightning in the area, it was take 2 for Juice in Europe's ambitious mission to deep space. The launch here marked the start of a long journey for the 6-ton spacecraft. Leaping off the pad on Friday 14th at 2:14 p.m. local time, the mighty Ariane 5 rocket was finally on its way with its special single payload. Sadly, the lingering cloud cover obscured the ascent here. The flight trajectory was right down the middle as the core stage completed its job and the second stage continued to increase its velocity. At almost 28 minutes from launch, Juice separated amongst jubilant scenes at mission control. And with that, the mission to Jupiter and its moons was officially underway. The third major milestone in the launch was acquisition of signal around 48 minutes into the mission, shown here by this peak in radio frequency telemetry. And boy, what a relief it was to see that finally happen. A nice little graphic here showing the moment the ground station at New Norcia in Western Australia began communicating with Juice. The final milestone at around 80 minutes into flight, with solar wing deployment going like clockwork, the massive 85 square meter of panels needed to gather critical sunlight to feed the power needed for the spacecraft and its scientific equipment. JUICE, short for Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, is an extraordinary feat of human ingenuity and scientific exploration. As the first European spacecraft to embark on a journey to Jupiter, JUICE is a pioneering mission with the lofty goal of uncovering whether the icy Jovian moons Ganymede, Europa, and Callisto have the potential to sustain life. If all goes to plan, JUICE will perform flybys of Venus, Earth, and the Moon to increase its speed and adjust its trajectory before the spacecraft arrives at the gas giant in 2031. With its 10 cutting-edge scientific instruments, JUICE will be the eyes and ears of scientists, providing unprecedented insights into the gas giant planet's atmosphere, its enigmatic moons, and their evolution. Over the course of 4 years, JUICE will capture and transmit data that could revolutionize our understanding of how planets are formed and where life may exist beyond Earth. What makes JUICE truly special is the collaborative effort of more than 80 partners across 23 countries, harnessing the knowledge and skills of over 2,000 people. Airbus in particular has played a critical role in the mission, designing and building the spacecraft to the highest standards of innovation and reliability. The solar arrays, with a total surface area of 85 square meters, are one of the largest of their kind ever built and are essential to delivering the power required for JUICE's long journey and complex scientific instruments. JUICE will mark a historic moment in space exploration as it orbits a moon other than our own for the first time. In short, JUICE represents a remarkable milestone in human exploration, bringing together some of the brightest minds and most advanced technologies to answer questions about our place in the universe. Stay tuned to follow this exciting journey as JUICE reaches for the stars and expands our knowledge of the cosmos. On April 11th, Virgin surprised Twitter users. A tweet from the company reads, "Our CEO Dan Hart gathered the team last week at the factory in Long Beach to discuss our go-forward plan focused on getting Launcher 1 back to orbit." Although Chapter 11 bankruptcy allows a company to continue trading, no one expected Virgin would be back, not least this soon after letting most of its workforce go with reports that only the company's top positions were staying. Virgin hopes that Launcher 1 Rocket 8, seen pictured here, will be launching in the not-too-distant future. SpaceX finally announced national cell service coverage for its Starlink internet. But here's why you can't use it. Last week, 1NZ, a branch of Vodafone, released the following statement. "We're very proud to announce a new collaboration with SpaceX to provide 100% mobile coverage across New Zealand. No more black spots for One New Zealand customers. When the service goes live, there will be 100% coverage across the country, whether you're out on your boat, climbing a mountain, fixing a remote road, or on your farm. New Zealanders and New Zealand businesses are safer with us. We're taking coverage and connectivity further than ever before, with one giant leap towards the most advanced and safest network in the country." With the service initially offering SMS and MMS service from late 2024, with the hope of releasing data, voice, and video calling just a few months later in early 2025. 1NZ claim that current coverage access to New Zealand is just 50%, but that with SpaceX Starlink, they can cover 100% of the country, including up to 12 kilometers offshore to the country's territorial boundary. The little Martian helicopter that could continues to amaze us all, having recently made flight number 49. Arriving at Mars on February 18th, 2021, this amazing technology demonstration was attached to the Perseverance rover. Taking to the skies for the first time on April 19th, 2021, it was originally planned to have up to 5 flights. Its mission was independent of Percy, in that Ingenuity was there to prove if powered flight in the thin Martian atmosphere was possible. With a mass of 1.8 kilograms, it's truly incredible this has been able to make as many hops as it has. So having just racked up Flight 49, it has so far traversed a total of 11 kilometers and almost 1.5 hours of flight time in its lifespan. Just a handful of weeks remain until the big one. Flight 50 is anticipated to occur in early May. Get ready to blast off into a new era of space exploration with Dawn Aerospace. This cutting-edge New Zealand-based company has just completed the first 3 test flights of their revolutionary rocket-powered spaceplane, the Mark II Aurora. Powered by a high-performance combustion rocket engine fueled by kerosene and hydrogen peroxide, this innovative vehicle has already soared to a maximum speed of 315 kilometers per hour and an altitude of 1,800 meters. But that's just the beginning. The Dawn Aerospace team is already working on a second version of the Mark II Aurora that will climb even higher, eventually reaching the internationally recognized boundary of space at an altitude of 100 kilometers. This new suborbital vehicle will revolutionize atmospheric research, allowing scientists to study the mesosphere and thermosphere like never before. With the ability to fly the space plane twice a day, the possibilities for environmental and weather research are endless. And the best part? The Aurora vehicles are designed for aircraft-like efficiency, taking off and landing from a runway using non-exotic fuels and requiring minimal refurbishment between flights. But the Aurora isn't just a research vehicle, it's also a testbed for the larger Mark III Aurora spaceplane, which aims to deliver an expendable second stage and payload to space, eventually launching satellites with a mass of about 250 kilograms into low Earth orbit. With the support of over 100 employees in New Zealand and the Netherlands and $20 million in fundraising, the team at Dawn Aerospace is poised to lead the charge in this exciting future of space exploration. Finally, the long-awaited Starship OFT, or the orbital flight test, is imminent, with Elon teasing that it may have been as early as the 10th of April and later tweeting that it would have been the third week of the month, with relevant licenses suggesting it may fly as early as the 17th. Mr. Editor's birthday, by the way. Although many speculate that it's likely going on 420, as Elon Musk loves the culture surrounding the day. Well, that's it for now. What another great week that was. We look forward to bringing you the latest developments in space news next week and some fun along the way. Thanks for watching, and remember, onwards to the future. Always impressive seeing the first stage execute a flawless vertical takedown. Takedown? Ah! Yes. We're gonna see a rocket suplex a platform. That is what I wanna see. Back to the payloads now, and just after an hour from liftoff here, we go around. We'll try that again. Around there. Okay.